The role model biologist that I chose is Dr. Ronald Mark Evans. It is difficult to find specific information regarding his childhood and how he became involved with science. However, Dr. Evans once said in an interview that he has been passionate with science ever since high school. He earned his BA in bacteriology and PhD in microbiology and immunology from the UCLA in 1974 and was a postdoctoral fellow at the Rockefeller University. One of the biggest obstacles he faced was at the beginning of his own lab at the Salk Institute, where he was discovering the genetic switch of a growth hormone gene. He said it was extremely difficult because nobody really knew how to do it. In addition to his effort, Dr. Evans and his colleagues were able to isolate glucocorticoid receptor, the first series of related switches that allow hormones to control genes. From the sources that I've read, it's unclear if Dr. Evans has any interesting hobbies, but from the same interview that I've mentioned before, he said that he was a real lab rat. 15 or 16 hours per day was pretty normal. It was work, work, and work, and I love it, said Dr. Evans. So I assume that Dr. Evans' hobby is his work. What I admire him the most are the studies that he participated were mostly related to the medical field, where he talks about diseases, hormones, and medicines, which I'm interested in. And the results of his studies were always beyond expectations. For example, one of his discoveries is called exercise in the pill, which he discovered that the PPAR delta and nuclear receptor that plays a key role in regulating the storage of burning of fat. The work showed that permanently activated PPAR delta made mice resistant to weight gain, improved response to insulin, and gave them super endurance in treadmill tests. This discovery has important implications for treating type 2 diabetes, cardiovascular diseases, muscular dystrophy, and frailty. I identify with him because I'm interested in the knowledge related to medicine and diseases, and hoping that someday I could become one of the members in the medical field. Dr. Evans' work research inspired me to become someone like him, and the more I read about his research, I felt more motivated and wanted to work harder to achieve my dream. He was involved in a study about viruses at first while pursuing his graduate studies in the UCLA. He then decided to focus on gene expression and regulation through the inspiration by David Baltimore at Rockefeller University on identifying the genetic switch of growth hormone genes in mammals. Some specific questions that Dr. Evans focuses on are, why should there be a family? Why does it contain this particular number of genes? And do more hormones exist? How can you use nuclear receptor to find new drugs? The most recent paper that Dr. Ronald Mark Evans is an author on is titled for E47 Modulates Hepatic Glucocorticoid Action, which was published in December 2018. This paper identifies the BHLH factor E47 as the modulator of glucocorticoid receptor, GR target genes, and the absence of E47 prevents the development of hypoglycemia and hepatic steatosis in response to glucocorticoids, GCs. At the beginning of the experiment, Dr. Evans and his team performed chip sequencing and data analysis for GR in mouse liver. From the analysis, they found an e-box near glucocorticoid response elements in hepatic promoters and enhancers. This e-box was predicted to be bound by BHLH transcription factor E47, which E47 is required for the regulation of hepatic glucose and lipid metabolism by GR. As their chip sequencing experiment pointed towards a potential co-regulation of metabolic target genes by GR and E47, they studied the role of E47 for GR-mediated transcription in vivo and discovered that the loss of E47 resulted in reduced transcriptional and phenotypic response to GCs. Since genetic loss of E47 revealed its role in the activation of hepatic glucose and lipid metabolism by GR, Dr. Evans and his team performed co-IP and CHIP-MS experiments to study the protein-protein interaction of the transcriptional complex between the GR and E47. To test whether metabolic response to GC is conserved between mice and humans, they screened a set of human cis regulatory sequences predicted to be regulated by GR in high-throughput luciferase reporter assay. The luciferase reporter data demonstrate a conserved function of E47 in the transcriptional activation of human gene programs by GCs. So far, Dr. Ronald Evans has discovered about 50 nuclear hormone receptors and how they control the gene expression in our body and related to diseases. He is currently involved in another research that is related to cancer, which discusses about a stromal lysolipid O2 taxon signaling axis that promotes pancreatic tumor progression.